Welcome to My New Beginnings television broadcast. I'm Pastor Teresa McCurry, and we're going in the sanctuary to hear an awesome word from Senior Pastor Gregory McCurry. The title of the message today is Hearing That Produces the Epic. Hearing that produces the epic. Isn't that great when we can hear from the Spirit of the Lord? So tune in, tell a friend that My New Beginnings is on, and let's go into the sanctuary and hear what Senior Pastor Gregory McCurry has to say.
I heard the Lord saying while we were singing that song, He said, start seeing it like the Word sees it. Amen. Don't see it how your condition is. Amen. See it how the Word see it. Turn to your neighbor and say, neighbor. See it how the Word see it. And you already won.
Hallelujah.
A couple of people believe that. Amen. How many winners do we really have in here?
Amen.
some winners in here today. I truly believe in God. Just a tag. Mark, the 4th chapter, the 22nd through the 24th verse. Genesis 2, 15 through the 17th verse. John 10, 1 through 6. And Mark 4, 23 through 24, and I think those are the wrong verses, but when we get there, I will correct them.
All right.
Man, I was under a special anointing this morning, and I know as I'm looking at this, this is not the right scripture, but it's in the book of Mark, and I think it's around the 30th verse.
Amen. Hallelujah.
I need you to say this statement with me, and say it with me. We're going to say it in unison. Say, Lord,
help me
to hear your voice, and your voice only,
and
to hear it clearly,
and to respond to it
correctly. Amen. How many of y'all receive that today? Amen. We have been talking about the hearing that produces your epic. How you hear and what you hear is going to be a key element to how you believe. How do I know this? Because Jesus said it 16 times. He said this, he that hath ears, let them hear. He said it 8 times in the Gospels. Then he said it another 8 times in Revelations. And when he got to Revelations, he said this. He said, he that have an ears, let them hear what the Spirit is saying. Because when he talked in the Gospels, the Spirit had not yet been given. So he said, now, when I begin to speak, amen, because I told you on last week, Jesus came to destroy the old system. Amen, somebody. He had to come and give them a new hearing because they were missing their miracles because of their former belief system. Amen, somebody. So how you hear something, and if Jesus said it 16 times, that means there must be some significance. Oh my God. On how you are hearing. But I asked him this morning, I said, well, Lord, you didn't say he that have an ear. You said he that have ears. He said, because one is natural and the other one is spiritual. See, I take things in my natural ear, but I need it to hit my spiritual ear so I can hear what thus said the Lord. Are y'all not catching that? You got 2 ears. But most of us been listening in our analog instead of our digital. Are y'all gonna catch this? See, because the analog, it got misperceptions and miscommunication. My analog is tied to my flesh, man. And if I hear it in my flesh, I'm gonna react in. But if I hear it in my spirit, I'll react in my spirit. That's what he said. He that have ears. He didn't say hear what everybody's saying. He said, hear what I'm saying to you about you. Anybody happy that he's saying something good about you? Amen, somebody. Your hearing, the word hearing means to obtain knowledge, to comprehend, to understand, and take in. So every Sunday, I say in your hearing, with purpose, this is going to be the year of total fulfillment of every proportion. Oh, y'all not even excited, right? Wait a minute. Now, see, if somebody really believe that, see what God tells us, it's going to be according to your praise today. And he said, I'm about to come in and do something like you've never.
Thank you, Lord.
Else to say. Amen. Because I know on Sunday, When I say, Brother Archie, you about to get total fulfillment of every proportions. I know on Monday all hell breaking.
Come on.
And while you were believing on Sunday, while you heard the word of God coming, something happened on Monday,
right.
Something happened on Tuesday,
right.
Something happened on Wednesday,
yeah.
Three things happened on Thursday, Friday it was absolutely jacked up, and Saturday you didn't even want to come to church. Do you believe that? Tell me, say, well, act like you believe that. Act like you believe. Act like you already won the prize. Act like you already got your healing. Act like you already got whatever God said. Act like you already got it. Why don't you just stop acting like it? You ain't saying you're about to have it. You said act like it.
Refrigerator.
Amen. Because I want to always remind myself.
There you go.
No matter what it look like.
Yeah.
I've already gotten total fulfillment of every proportion.
Yeah.
I don't care about the phone call. I don't care about the letter that I get in the mail.
Right.
I don't care about the doctor's diagnosis.
Right.
I look at my promise every day. And I believe what God is. Can you never believe it?
Believe it.
I think he said, we have this going. This sickness ain't unto death. This what you going through? He told Lazarus, when they came and said, hey, Lazarus died. He said, shh, don't you worry about it. This one ain't unto death. Because when I show up, I'm going to go to the grave. And I'm going to get up every dead thing you ever seen before. Anybody got some dead stuff in their life? So you can go from information to revelation. So now you can finally get the manifestation of what God is saying. Amen, somebody.
Amen.
Somebody say glory.
Glory.
So I speak into your hearing that God told me to tell you this morning, he's ready to do it all.
Amen. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah.
To remind you of something, he says, pay attention to the little things.
Yeah.
Yeah. Tell you the little things. See, y'all not paying attention because God is blessing you, and just because you don't have a new car don't mean you ain't blessed.
Yeah.
I ain't chasing after none of his stuff.
Right.
I'm chasing after God.
Yeah.
When I get God, I can get.
Yeah.
Oh! Tim brought something back to my attention. He was sitting there, we was in the back, and he said, this is it. Pastor, do you remember when Terry lost her sweater? Mm-hmm. And I said, yeah. He said, do you remember what she told us? Mm-hmm. I said, yeah. He said, she said, God is concerned about stuff that's not even insignificant to you, it's significant to him.
That's right.
He's about to turn some insignificant stuff.
Because
yeah. Terry had been looking for a sweater, and she wasn't able to find it. But one day, somebody showed up at her door. Am I right? With her sweater.
Yes.
And Terry came back and prophetically said, God is concerned about everything
yes.
that concerns you.
Yes.
Even your sweater.
Yes. He said, tell them I'm about to restore to you the years. Like a dog, and you've been loving them like God. I tell you, they were unexpected. So God said, tell you, he's about to bring something you lost back to you. But matter of fact, God is doing things that while you got it on your mind, he did.
You ain't even got to say it out your mouth. It can be on your mind and it'll show up. But your mind is staying on. Because don't think your mind can't pull the wrong thing in just as well as you can pull the right thing in. Amen. So he's saying all you got to do is tell you never have your mind on it. Have your mind on it. God is concerned about everything that's concerning you. This week. I told my wife last week, y'all know I'm about to go on a sabbatical, right? And I told her, I said, baby, I wish we could just go to the comedy club. She said, well, we ain't got nothing in the mail lately. I said, oh, wow. And so now listen, because she loved me, because what I said in her did something to her.
Yes,
she was on her job, she was working on Friday, and she said she was telling one of her clients, she said, Greg wants to go to the comedy club, I wish I could do it for her. She said, for matter of fact, I'm gonna call them and see if we can get some free tickets to go. She said she didn't get a chance to make it to the phone. Oh, y'all.
All right, all right.
You ain't gonna get a chance to make it there. To the phone moved to her. And it was a comedy show calling her, let her know we got 4 free tickets. I got to touch this. Say it, get your mind on it. Now, wait.
Come on.
Yes.
Going to a comedy show.
Yes.
How much more do you think he's concerned about you?
Yes.
And everything he wants to do for you.
Yes.
Can you never bless him for the small stuff?
Yes.
Your neighbor, he cares.
See,
but the enemy trying to tell you to do it. He trying to tell you he don't care about you.
Yeah.
Tell me y'all ain't never had it. He don't care about you. He don't look at you. That's why he said he don't see you like you are.
Yeah.
He see you like where he gonna take you.
Yeah.
Amen. You just gotta hold on long enough for the process to stop.
Yes.
Hallelujah, somebody. Yes. Tell you never think about it. Think about it.
Think about it.
Say Selah. Psalms 138. I want y'all to park in the book of Mark, the 4th chapter. Amen. Amen. Y'all over there?
Yes.
Amen. Y'all park over there. Amen. I'll be there in a minute. I'm on my way. I got to tell the story. Psalms 138, they say, the Lord will perfect that which concerneth you. He said, I'm ready to bring it to pass. I'm ready. If it concerned you,
yes, Lord. Thank you, Lord.
It concerned me.
Oh, Father.
Do y'all understand that?
Hey,
if it concerned you, he said it don't matter how little it is.
Yes.
See, because we be thinking that's just too little for God to be concerned.
Yes.
God said everything. Tell you everything.
Yes.
That concerneth you.
Concerneth
you. And he told me to tell you the reason he can tell you that's because he love you.
Yeah.
Tell you that he love you.
He loves you.
And because he loves you, everything about you, he's concerned about. It ain't because he don't like you. It's because he love you. And God is saying, if you would just allow me to love you, you will be able to understand how much I really want to bless you. It's three things that I say every Sunday. And I say it on purpose too. Number one. See, wait a minute, y'all ain't on it. I said, number one. You know why y'all can say that? Because we've been rehearsing and rehearsing, and now it become natural. Number two, God wants you to have the abundant life.
Yeah.
He wants you to have a life like you
never
dreamed of before. And that dream gonna come with this testimony. And we ain't never seen it. Home going service on Friday. The funeral director came up to her and said, I want to tell you something. I've been to a lot of home going services before. She said, but miss, I ain't never seen it done. I told you, the testimony belongs to those who are willing to believe God is ready to do something supernatural. Tell your neighbor, I receive it. Hearing that produces the evidence. Your faith is directly tied into your hearing system. And what you have heard or what you are hearing is what you are believing. And whatever you're putting on the inside of you is literally going to be displayed on the outside of you. Jesus said this in the book of Mark. He said this, he said, and I saw their faith.
Yes.
He didn't say I heard their faith. He said I saw their faith. You know how I know you gotta see faith? Because faith without works is dead. So I know what you're saying, but what you're saying you ain't doing. See, a lot of times, listen, I go to the prisons all the time. And them brothers in the prison, they know they work.
Right.
No, let me pray. Change that. They know how to quote they work.
Right.
But they don't really know they work.
Right.
Yeah. It's a big difference from quoting the word and knowing the word.
Right.
See, it's a lot of people are full of information, don't have one revelation.
Uh-huh.
Hallelujah, somebody. There's plenty of people who have the Genesis of Revelation, and they don't believe God can heal them.
Right.
So one time I was in the prison, I was talking, and every time I tell this brother, I say, let's turn to the scripture. Before I can even get through the scripture, this brother would quote the scripture. You know, you ever meet them kind of people?
Yes.
You're doing a lesson, and they trying to do the teaching. Amen.
Right.
So I'm telling him, I'm saying, turn it in. He said, oh, yeah, I know that scripture. He did. I was having to find it in my Bible. He knew it before I turned it. He was quoting it already. So I stopped him. I said, my brother, If you know all that, why are you in here? So Hebrews says, don't worry about turning there. I'm going where I'm saying tomorrow. Faith, y'all know me. I'm going. I'll meet you there. I told you what, about 5 more minutes, right? I'm going to be there. Faith cometh by hearing. So what does it tell me? The more I hear something, the more I believe it. But listen, faith ain't necessarily, I keep telling y'all, a God thing. Because the more you hear whatever it is, it'd be the more that you believe whatever it is. That's why he takes you and he says, faith cometh by hearing, and hearing by the word of God. He directs you that you will no longer hear another. Tell your neighbor, don't hear another voice. Don't you hear another voice. You gotta cancel that other voice. So the more I begin to rehearse what God is saying to me, the more my rehearsal becomes a performance. Because I'm getting prepared to perform what I've been rehearsing. So you got to keep on saying what God is saying, because the more you say it, the more you start believing it. So after a while, what you begin to say, you don't have to say it no more, because I can see it instead of you saying it. Somebody shout glory. Now let's go over to Mark, the 4th chapter. And I need to deal with this. Let's start at. Are we getting some?
Okay.
Let's go to this statement. Mark 4:23. I'm going to read it in the King James Version. I'm going to jump over to the Amplified. Now here go that statement. If any man have ears to hear, what do it say?
Let him hear.
Oh, man. And he said unto them, take heed in what you hear. With what measure you meet, it shall be measured to you. And unto you that hear, shall more be given. My God. And for he has said, to him shall be given, but he that has not, from him shall be taken even that which he has. Now, in the Amplified Version, amen, he says this, amen, he says, if any man has ears to hear, let him listen, let him perceive, and let him comprehend. Because see, you can hear me, but if you don't comprehend and understand what I'm saying, then all you did was listen to me, but you didn't really hear me, because now you don't have an understanding of what I just said to you. And if you don't have an understanding of what I'm saying to you, you surely can't carry out what I told you to do. And so that's why he's always telling you, amen, either have an ear, let him hear. And then he tells you this, however you hear it, my God. That's how you're going to be able to receive it. And you can only receive it on how you believe it. So if I don't receive it, amen, in faith, and I don't receive it in the measure of faith, I can't get it in faith. Abundant life. I believe that. I don't believe I can have the abundant day or the abundant moment. I believe I can have the abundant life. So that's measured back up to me, and that's why I live the abundant life. Now all you can believe is if an abundant moment, that's the measure that you won't get back. Or how big your bowl is how big he can fill it. Amen, somebody. your neighbor, what's your ruler?
What's your ruler?
That's your ruler.
What's your ruler?
Wow.
So, however I believe it, Matt, he's saying, I can get it in that proportion.
Yeah.
I can get it. Now, if I don't believe it in that proportion, I can't get it like that. See, but listen, if you don't believe in healing, guess what?
You ain't gonna get it.
Amen.
Amen.
But listen, but if you measure it and you believe the Lord can do it, Mom, God is saying, if you take him out the box. We have put God in this box. We think all God can do is pay bills. He's telling you that he's bigger than that. But it depends on how you measure him. Now let me get to this because I got to go. Say glory.
Glory.
I know. Then he says this. Now, this is key because this is where I'm going today. I'm 24. This is in the Amplified version. He said unto them, be careful what you are hearing.
Yeah.
I was so blessed the other day. I was over at my oldest daughter's house. We were sitting up. She was preaching. Amen. That's what's in her. Amen. She can't even help me. She's just preaching. Sorry, you got offered. Amen. She said, you can do that. Amen. That's her measure of belief. But listen, she began to talk to me. She said, Daddy, I can't share everything with everybody. Because everybody don't believe like I believe.
Come on.
And if I share with an unbeliever, they'll mess around and mess up my belief.
Right.
See, y'all don't think people can mess up their belief. Amen. Yes, they can.
Yeah.
Why do you think he said, be careful?
Yep.
He said what you hear, because how you hear it is how you gonna believe it.
Right.
So you can believe in something and get around an unbeliever,
right,
and they will literally convince you.
Yeah.
Anybody ever been convinced before that God had said it and then the enemy came to convince you? See, if you're pregnant, you don't need to be going around the abortion clinic. Because you're around them unbelievers.
Yeah.
And you keep on wondering, why keep on losing my baby? Because you keep on going around people who ain't believing like you believe.
Yeah.
I refuse to share my dream with someone don't know about a dream. Amen, somebody. You may not see it right now, but like Joseph did, he had a dream about his mother and his father and his brother. He said, I got a dream that I see them bowing before me. Didn't happen in, no. You may have to go to the prison. You may have to get caught up in something else. But tell your neighbor, dreams come true.
Dreams come true.
So tell you, be careful what you hear.
Be careful.
This week, I was talking to Minister Barr. And she getting ready to have knee surgery. Amen. And so we were talking. And she said, she started telling me, can I help y'all with something? Barbara, can I help? Can I help?
Yeah.
Y'all quit giving people bad news.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Believers shouldn't have nothing but faith in them.
That's right.
Y'all got what I'm saying?
Right.
Believers, listen, and I know sometimes we be meaning well. You know, but sometimes you say stuff and you don't know what you're saying because your words are full of power. Mm-hmm. So she said this to me. She said, well, Dad, you know, I'm going to have this knee surgery. You know, and I heard all this stuff that went wrong with other people.
Mm-hmm.
And you know who she was hearing it from?
The
believers.
Come on.
Can I talk this for a minute? Who were you hearing it from? The believers.
Mm-hmm.
The world wouldn't even tell Right. Well, tell her, you're going to go in here, the doctor's going to hook you up. You're going to come out and be brand new.
Right.
Now, I'm going somewhere with this. That's what the doctor said. You know what the believer said?
Girl. My mama went in and got her knee surgery. And she ain't never been like since. Well, matter of fact, such and such went in there. They left something in her knee. And it's infected. And you know if they get infected, you got to cut that leg off. Girl, you don't know how hard that's going to be. Now, what happened was, I knew something else had went in her hearing because of what she said to me. And I said to her, I said, not you.
That's right.
Amen. Because then somebody gonna say, you offended me when you talk about offense. You know you offended me. How did I offend you? Because you was talking about me.
Come on.
I didn't even know you was offended. You just told on yourself. I told you what's on the inside. Oh. I know how y'all just speaking holy tongue. I know y'all do. Ain't that right, y'all? Amen. Thank you. Sharon's the only one who really said that's right. Amen. Amen. But listen, I come to talk to you about your closing. Are y'all ready? Whenever God gives you a word, it's the opposer's job to come and get you out of the will of God. Mm-hmm. Now listen to this. Go to Genesis, the second chapter. Woo-wee. Did y'all receive that?
Yes.
We ain't gonna let offense hit us no more, right?
No more.
Ain't no more, ain't no more. And for oh no, I better not say that. Yeah, I'm gonna say it.
Yeah.
Quit talking and leaking up with offended people.
Yeah.
Come on.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
Come on.
Because if you're not careful, their offense will become yours.
Yeah. All right.
And it didn't even happen to you. When I bring people in my office, because most people that come in my office, Adrian, they want to talk about somebody else. Mm. They do. They don't want to come talk about them. So when they say, I want an appointment with you, what they say, I'm really, Jason, I really want to talk to you about my neighbor. I very rarely have anybody come and ask me, but see, when they come and talk to me, I say, you can't talk to me about nobody else.
That's right.
You know why? Because they ain't here.
Come on.
So you finna give me your version.
Right. Right.
Everybody believe O.J. Simpson was innocent until they say, here go the glove. What am I saying? There's another side to every story. They only gonna tell their side because there's something called the right side, my side, your side, and then the right side. And what you want to do is bring it right back in to God's side. Is that helping anybody?
Yeah.
See, I had to break that spirit, amen, because it ain't creeping up in new beginnings, amen.
Amen.
I refuse. Tell you that I refuse. I will fight that thing, amen. Now, let me show you how this thing works. God, I got 15 minutes left. Genesis 2 and 15 and 16. And the Lord God took the man. He put him into the garden of Eden to dress it and to keep it. That was his purpose. And the Lord God commanded the man, tell your neighbor, commanded.
Commanded.
The man saying, of every tree of the garden thou may freely eat. But, tell your neighbor,
but.
Even though God may put you in a place, there may be some things you can't mess with.
All right.
He can put you in a place, but that don't mean you can mess with everything in that place. Y'all catch that revelation? However y'all want to catch that revelation. I heard some of y'all thoughts, amen. But the tree of the knowledge of good and evil, thou shalt not eat of it. For in the day you eat of that tree, he didn't say you might die. You gonna surely die. Now, can you read that? God is speaking to man. That's the first voice man heard. Now let me give y'all something. Until man got a word, the devil had no reason to show up. Till somebody said, you called into the ministry. See, now listen, soon as you hear that word, he didn't have to mess with you before then, because you had no destiny. You had no purpose until he put the word in you. It's when he put the word in you that he shows up.
Wow.
Because he said, wait a minute, Sharon, before you knew who you were, I ain't have to mess with you. But once you found out who you were, oh, wait a minute, I need to show up now because I need to detour your destiny. I come today to help you get back on track. Because some of your destiny has been detoured, amen, because of the word that's in you. But the word that's in you, God said it's still. Can't even see him do this. Now look at this. Now look at this. He comes as an imposter to oppose you. Tell your neighbor, he's man. Let me show you how he works. Let me show y'all how he works, man. Now after they got the word, right? Now here you see in chapter 3, the first verse. Now say this, now the servant. When?
Now.
The servant. He came, right? I got another revelation. Wherever there's a garden, there is a snake. Wherever your promise is, tell your neighbor, it's a snake there. You may not have identified it. Tell your neighbor, it's there. Y'all don't believe that?
It's there.
And can I help y'all with something? Because this is where people mess up at. Aren't you? I wish the devil was red. It had a pitch for him.
Right.
You can say.
But then at least I know him. Then I can identify myself. There go the devil. Most of the time, the person that's used by him is somebody who's close to you.
Come on now.
And I know y'all didn't want to hear that, did y'all?
True.
I got turned out on drugs by my best friend. The people I turned out was my friends. Because I wouldn't dare trust you with putting something in me if you was my enemy. Because I know it would kill me. Okay. Y'all catch it later. Y'all catch that? Y'all receiving it? And I'm not talking about they are not the devil. Quit telling them they the devil. They are not the devil. They just being used right now to use themselves against you. And it ain't about you. It's about the word in you. I got to clear this thing up. I tell people, I'll tell you, you rebuke the devil, get out of here. And you find yourself outside. Be like, I rebuke you, Satan, in the name of it. Get out of my house. Next thing you outside like, the serpent started having a conversation. And the serpent was more subtle than any beast of the field, which the Lord God had made. Yeah. And he said, did y'all see what he did?
He said
unto the woman. Then he asked her, hey, has God said, you shall not eat of every tree of the garden? That's a question. Right. And the woman said unto the serpent, wait a minute. Can I help you with something? Quit talking to the devil. Because the more you dialogue with him, the more he going to convince you. Don't think y'all tougher than the devil. People be thinking, I'm bad. No, you ain't. You ain't better than him. He slick. He subtle. He tricked everybody from Genesis to Matthew. Yep. What make you think you can't be tricked?
Right.
Now I can't be tricked. How'd you get that baby? Oh, I ain't talking about it. No, I ain't. See, I ain't get tricked. Nah, I can't go there. Let me keep going. I'm full right now. I'm full. And the woman said unto the serpent, we may eat of the tree of the garden, but of the fruit of the tree, which is in the midst of the garden, she repeated. And God said, you shall not eat of it. Mm-hmm. Neither shall you touch it, lest you die. Mm. He never said, don't touch it. He just told him, don't you eat it. Mm-hmm. So he knew right then, she didn't know what she was talking about. He said, oh, I got you now.
That's good.
Because you done said something that God ain't said.
Wow.
Man, I ain't got time to preach. And then he said, and the serpent said, now, man, how many times you gonna keep talking to him? And the woman, and the serpent said to the woman, you ain't gonna die. You know, you can do it this one time. You know, your friend been doing it all this time, she ain't got pregnant yet. You looked at it and you became pregnant.
Oh.
Oh. Oh, man. And he said this, you won't surely die. Now that wasn't like too far to reach, because at this particular time, nobody had died. See, he'll bring you something like, it's got some truth in it.
Yeah.
It ain't a total lie.
Right.
It's got to be some truth in it to convince you.
Right.
So it kind of says, you won't surely die. She thinking, what is that? Because nobody has died to this point.
Right.
There's only been life here.
Right.
Y'all catching this?
Yeah.
Okay,
yeah.
Let me go on. Now look at this. For God does know the day you eat thereof, and then your eyes shall be open, and you shall be God, knowing good and evil. And what did your scripture say? And what the woman saw? Wait a minute. All of a sudden she heard different. Now what happened? She began to see different. Wow. Because guess what? You keep on hearing wrong, you won't keep on seeing wrong. If you hear right, you're going to start seeing right. But she spent enough time with her that, tell your neighbor, stop the dialogue. Stop talking to him now. He ain't got nothing good for you. Amen. I don't think you read your scripture. He said he come to kill, steal, and destroy. He ain't coming to love on you. He coming to take something from you. Somebody shout glory.
Glory!
Yes.
And when the woman saw that the tree was good for food, and that it was pleasant. Oh man, now she done seen it totally different to the eyes. And a tree to desire to make one wise. She took of the fruit thereof and did eat and gave it also unto her husband. The whole
Welcome back to My New Beginnings. Wow, what an awesome word from Senior Pastor Gregory McCurry. The scripture says, let them that have an ear hear what the Spirit of the Lord is saying. You know what? Let's tune in to the Spirit and hear what the Spirit of the Lord is saying. We thank you so much for tuning in to our television broadcast. If you would like to contact us, please go to our website, www.mynewbeginnings.org, or give us a call, 216-916-9270. Thank you so much for tuning in to My New Beginnings, because here at New Beginnings, we introduce a real God to real people with real issues. God bless.